Hello, my name is Sam Matuk, and you're watching Iris News. So here I am with Dr. Funke to ask her some questions about the exams that are going on right now. So Dr. Funke, what is your advice on how to start revising?
That's usually a really tricky question. And you may be, I'm talking to the students out there, hi, wondering how do I start? I think you just take the syllabus and what you're supposed to have learned, do not panic, and you make notes. Some people are good at making notes, some people need to do kind of mind mapping, and some people can actually watch videos and learn a lot that way. So my tips would be is understand your learning style. Don't look at somebody else's. Am I someone that needs it audio? Do I need to write it down? Do I need to have mapping? Work with what works with you.
That was amazing. And what should you do when you're stressed out?
We all get stressed. It's a normal part of life. If anyone is embarking on the exams and they're not stressed, then I would be actually worried. So when people walk through my door and say I'm stressed, I'm saying, right, you're on the right tip, it means that you care. But if you get too stressed, where you're not sleeping, you're not eating, and you're feeling really panicky, I just need to just slow down. Take some deep breaths. Give yourself, sometimes you might have to push your books away for a few hours. Sometimes I like to tell people to push it away for a whole day. And then refresh your mind. You might be stressed because you're overstudying, you're studying too much, you're trying to cram. Remember, the mind can only take in so much information. If you find that you're having a little bit of a mind block, take a break, go for a walk, eat something nice. Be kind to yourself.
Okay, and speaking of stressing out, do you think procrastination is a sign of being stressed out?
Well, it's interesting because procrastination, there's been some recent research in the US that says when people procrastinate, it's actually a sign that your mind is trying to rejig and come alive again. Now, some people procrastinate, they just do it because of boredom. But sometimes you need to procrastinate because your mind is saying, I need a bit of a break. But in your mind, you want to say, oh, I've got so much to do. But no, it's just in the procrastination, be mindful and be peaceful at the same time.
That's nice. And so what should you do if you know that your exam went bad?
Sometimes it happens. You might have revised something, you've got a mental block. You know what? You can't change the past.
That's true.
You really can't think about what I did. And do not ask your friends what they asked, because that's just going to make you feel more anxious. Say you did the best that you could do at that time, and just get prepared for your next session.
Okay, and last but not least, what is your most important tip for the Cambridge and IB students right now?
Right now, you know I'm all about taking it easy. Right now, you are part of a whole world of people that are doing exams. So you're not alone. So you're not isolated in your stress and in your worry. But the tip that I want to give is to make sure you get enough rest. And sleep is crucial. I know some people like to stay up very late, that's fine. But make sure you rest so you get some sleep during the day. This is a really difficult period, but if you don't get the sleep and the rest, you will reach burnout. And there's a big world waiting for you. After IGCSEs is IB. After IB is university, if that's where you want to go. So just pace yourself. That's my tip.
Thank you so much, Dr. Funke, for joining us today. I'd like to say good luck to everyone who is writing an exam right now.
And I would just say, you can do it.
Of course. We are eagles. So thank you so much for watching. And don't forget to fly higher, eagles.
Woo!